Are you currently searching for a data science job and struggling? Well, you are not alone because job search for a data scientist role is hard. And I have talked about it in so many of my previous videos, why it is so difficult, the job search process and the interview process. So, and one of the big reasons why it's difficult is because the titles do not match from one company to another company. So a company X would call a data scientist data scientist, the company Y would call a data scientist data analyst or a machine learning engineer. So the titles do not match, the job descriptions do not match, which means you have to do your own research when applying for jobs to make sure that it's aligned with your skill set, because it's possible that you apply to a data scientist job by just looking at a title, but when you actually go to the interview, it turns out to be something else. So in this video, I'm actually going to go through my process, how I narrow down the jobs and how I do my research to kind of like figure out if this is the role that is aligned with my skill set and it's the role that I want to pursue. Okay, I'm gonna record my computer screen. I have my laptop here, so I don't have my proper setup. So I have the setup on my lap. So like if I look down, that's what I'm looking at. I'm gonna record my screen. So I will make sure that you will also see my screen in terms of like what I'm looking at. So let's say in terms of like the job that I'm searching for a data scientist generalist. A data scientist generalist is basically a combination of various different roles, but they understand data science, they understand advanced statistics, they understand machine learning, and they are able to solve business problems using the machine learning and advanced statistics. A couple of things I want to look out for, which is like super common that happened in the past. Some of the roles are applied scientists, but they're labeled data scientists. Applied scientist is basically somebody who is a software engineer times a data scientist, so they can like deploy in production. Why couldn't I say it? And then sometimes the roles are titled data analyst, data scientist, but they are actually a data analyst role. It's very analytics focused. So I want to watch out for that as well, because I don't want to be just doing like reporting and SQL under a data scientist title, which is not the right thing to do. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to, I'm going to start recording my screen. Okay, so I just searched data scientist jobs in Google and I landed on this page. So I'm going to type in here data scientist. All right, so I landed on a bunch of these jobs. Here, I'm gonna click on data scientist right here. Okay, so now it has narrowed down these options for me. So I'm based in Seattle, so that's why it's narrowing down. It's automatically narrowing down the jobs that data scientist jobs that are open in Seattle. So this is a job. This is the first job that I come up with is that the results show is data scientist role in eBay. Let's go through, the role was open 4 days ago. So let's go through quickly. So the way, let's say if I'm applying for the job, the way I would quickly look, I will look for the qualification and the responsibilities to fully understand like what's happening. So here the qualification is 5 years experience, successfully solving real world problem, strong mathematics, statistics, experience in predictive analysis, proficiency in SQL, handling large data set, proficiency in Python and R, strong interpersonal skills. Okay. So those are the qualification responsibilities: using machine learning to determine delivery dates, improving how fast delivery impacts, applying machine learning. You will directly be responsible for improving eBay's shipping science, design and implement end-to-end solutions using machine learning, and conduct experiments, collaborate with other researchers, communicate your methodologies, estimate building research. Okay, well, just I quickly glimpsed through it just with all of you. So far it seems like it qualifies for a data scientist, a generalist role. So by the looks of it, I can go ahead and apply, but I do want to do one more check before I do that. So for that, I like to go on Glassdoor. And on Glassdoor, I would search for data scientist at eBay. So let's see what I come up with. Here, what I'm looking for is somebody who has done, who has like interviewed for this role and they have left their interview experience and a few questions, hopefully, because the reason I want to look at those questions is because it's going to give me an idea what they're going to ask me in the interview and what I should be expecting, because sometimes the job description doesn't give it away, but the interview questions will give it away how how analytics focused and how statistics and ML focused this role is. So let's do that. So here is the basically the interview. I'll click here, interview, and then it's already pulling the data scientist interview questions. And so what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to go through some of these interview. Okay, so basically they interviewed, and one of the questions, they didn't share everything, but one of the questions that they shared is bias and variance trade-off, favor ML model, and why. Okay, that sounds fine to me. The second interview is also around questions on machine learning. So again, like, they're not posting the actual interview questions. Some of them do, but like most of them will just give you a high level idea in terms of what was asked. The third one, how might you impute missing data here? Okay, statistics questions. And how would you identify potential customers in e-commerce, KPIs to be considered? Take-home test, classification modeling, you need to submit the code, a presentation, and a write-up. Okay. Implement a logistic model for a data set. Okay, well, so far, just looking through these questions, I actually feel confident with this role. It does seem to be very statistics and ML heavy, which I think is a good thing. So, and those are the things that I would be looking for when I'm trying to figure out if this job is actually a pure data scientist generalist job or not. So this, a check mark. Let's take a quick pause to thank today's sponsor, Project Pro. Thank you for sponsoring this video. If you watched some of my previous videos, you know how much I have talked about building practical knowledge, and Project Pro is actually making that easy. Project Pro has a curated library of verified, solve end-to-end project solutions in data science, machine learning, and big data. For example, this project that predicts customer churn rate using machine learning and Python. You can get access to 3,000 plus code recipes, such as this one that I just mentioned, for free. And subscription plan will get you additional 250 plus solved projects. Check out Project Pro's website in the description and see their YouTube channel where they share many data science tips and tricks. All right, back to the video. All right, let's go to job number two. And for job number two, let's go back to the search page and let's pick one more job and see if that works. I wanted to do one for Meta because that one is always interesting. So I wonder if I can, Meta, there. Oh, there it is. Okay, so when I look for Meta, there are a few roles that pop up, research data scientist. Oh, this is new. Like before, when I was job searching about a few years ago, 2-3 years ago, they didn't have that role. So research data scientist and then data scientist. Okay, so maybe they have, and then they have something called data scientist analytics. Okay, so maybe the ones that are, this is here and then here, they have kind of like, it seems like they have divided the data scientist role itself into multiple letters. And I actually did a video on this where I highlighted how Airbnb is doing a great job. They have divided their data scientist role into three different letters. One is analytics, second is inferential statistics, and then the third one is machine learning. So I'm gonna link that video here. You can watch that, but I think like Airbnb actually doing a wonderful job there. And I can see now just looking at these roles, it seems like Facebook is also trying to follow that model. Let's click on data scientist analytics. Yeah. Okay. So going to the qualification, this role is the ideal candidate will have passion for working with in white space and creating impact for ground up in fast paced environment, blah, blah, blah. Degree in analytical field. Okay, so there's like analytical field, so engineering, mathematics. So if you notice, like this is the second job that we're looking at and there's like no PhD requirement, which is a topic that I wanted to do. And I'll maybe probably record that video right after this. But I think this is like a myth in terms of like the PhD and the data scientist role requirement. And there are certain cases where you need a PhD, but not everywhere. I'll deep dive into that. Okay, 6 years hands-on experience analyzing. Okay, that's a lot of experience. 6 years advanced SQL, 6 years scripting, 6 years working with visualization tools. Wow. So, okay, the visualization tool is actually giving it away that this is more going to be dashboarding, which I personally try to stay away from. 6 years experience end-to-end managing, leading many cross-functional, proven thought leader, advanced communication. Okay. And then the responsibilities include, in this role, your primary responsibility partner with key stakeholders, data center footprint, responsible for leverage data and business principle. Okay, so just by looking at this, this is actually a perfect example of a data analyst times a data scientist. Because if you look through the job description, it basically is saying that they need somebody who's like really good at data analytics and is also familiar and good with the data scientist role itself. So they're looking for 2-in-1, which works great if that's something that you enjoy doing. So now let's go to Glassdoor itself and look for, although I don't know if I'm gonna be able to find this title specifically, but let's see what we find. So I'm going to go incognito window, and then I'm going to say data scientist, not Facebook, Meta, interview. Okay, so Glassdoor again is the first one that pops up. So I'm going to quickly go through the interview questions here. So this is for data scientist role at Meta. So here, the interview question is, they were given a table and sample rows, and table and sample rows. And then over the question is, over the last days, how many users made more than 10 searches? Okay, this like seems like a SQL problem. You notice that number of users clicked on search results. This is more of like a problem solving team went such as the, okay. So far it's like very data analytics heavy. Introduce yourself. Okay, well, that's not helpful. SQL questions about data manipulation. Okay, so just by looking through this, it seems like this role is very SQL heavy just by the interview questions itself. And I think the job description itself, we kind of figured out this is very like data analytics heavy role. So even though the title says data scientist, comma analytics, this is actually, you can say, is a data analyst with who knows how to do data science. I don't know if that makes sense. Basically, the requirement is that if the problem is given, they should be able to solve it because they understand data scientist role. But the majority of the work, at least from the interview questions, seems like it's very SQL focused. Just by going through these two job descriptions, you can actually see how different, even though the titles were pretty much the same, the requirement is completely different. And then when you look at the interview question itself, it actually gives you a better idea of what the role actually is. Because think about it, if a role that is open and their interview questions are primarily SQL heavy, which includes like you writing SQL, nothing wrong with it, it includes writing SQL, joins. So then that gives you an idea. Other people who have interviewed for this role and are currently working in that data scientist role, they basically are coming from that background. So, and then compared to the first job that we saw at eBay, that was very statistics and machine learning heavy. And you can actually see in the interview questions that it was very focused on those concepts. And that also gives you an idea that people who have been able to pass the interview, get the offer, are people who understand advanced statistics and machine learning very, very well. Let me know if you have any tips that you personally use to figure out if this role is actually matches as to what the title is saying. If you find the content in today's video helpful, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. If you want to hear more about data science, tech, everything else in between, let me know if you have any questions or if any suggestions for future videos like this. If this was helpful, maybe I should do a part 2 of this, and feel free to send me job requirements that you want me to go through, and maybe we can do that together. So with that, I hope you're having a beautiful day, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a good one. Bye.